So here's a leaky mixer tap in question, which was dripping from the handle. It's actually a kitchen mixer tap in a bathroom, sorry, I mean the head, due to it needing to reach over a large vessel sink on a worktop. Anyway, to get it sorted, as you do, I turned to YouTube to work out how to repair it and learnt that there's usually an Allen key somewhere to undo it and replace the cartridge or replace a seal. However, I soon realised it had seized up and I probably could have loosened it with limescale remover, but after chatting to our marina neighbour plumber, Paul the plumber, he convinced me just don't bother unless it was a really well-known brand, you knew what cartridge replacement it was and the O-ring size. Oh, and don't buy a cheap one. Well, that came to bite me back in the bum, didn't it? So off I went, removing everything out of the cupboard, feeling rather relieved that there were very little obstacles and that it was Speedfit, something I'd used to install a utility kitchen a couple of years ago. I'll leave a link to that video below. Although I did wonder why there were no isolation taps in there. So instead, I had to turn off the boat's entire water supply at the pump and then open the tap to clear what was left. And with a bucket underneath at the ready, I started unscrewing the mounting plate that was clamping the tap to the worktop. Although you might have a large nut to unscrew, as you'll see later, there's no escaping innuendos in this video, I can tell you. But while disconnecting the Speedfit, my camera cut out, so I had to push it all back together to refilm it for demonstration purposes, and that's why you don't see any water come out. But how it works is, when you're taking it apart, you unscrew the compression part of the Speedfit fitting, either from an elbow, a T-junction, or a coupler, and then you pull the collar towards you to pull it apart. So you're pulling it away from the pipe. But if you're going to put it back together, you need to make sure you've got an insert put in first, then push the pipe into the fitting as far as it goes. There's usually markers there to say how far you've gone, and then screw it tight as a safety precaution. And definitely don't be tempted to mix and match with other plastic plumbing. As tempting as it might be using old bits up, it can fail, and it's not worth a risk on a boat or a house, obviously. And once the taps were disconnected, I could remove them and work on the new ones, but with the Speedfit hose tails, so it's all uniform. So you'll notice that the new tap was almost identical to the old one, apart from the way it mounted to the bathroom worktop. This one's got a screw type barrel with a large nut that you tighten from underneath. The other one had a mounting piece. And every tap you'll find is different. Also, this one had an O-ring slot just underneath the base of the tap that would be positioned between the tap and the worktop. Anyway, to save you a lot of time and skipping past my trial and errors, I was a little bit rusty, it's been a couple of years, you'll notice you'll have to poke the hose tails through the nut and the barrel so they stay put, and then through the worktop, and screw in the flexi hoses from above. And depending on the manufacturer's instructions, some suggest to just hand tighten it, some suggest to nip it with some pliers. With this one, I could only hand tighten it. Anyway, after I got the Speedfit hose tails in, this is where I realised that I couldn't even fix the whole tap to the worktop.
Huh. Oh, come on.
And I tried and tried, got my husband to look at it as well, but I found there was just not enough room for the bulky tops of the Speedfit hoses. And that was preventing the screw barrel part from even screwing to the tap. Now, I generally prefer to use Speedfit because it's so easy to use. You don't need any spanners or pliers, and I've never had any leaks whatsoever. So by this point, my plumber neighbour suggested two options, and that was to either send it back for a full refund and buy one locally, which wasn't in stock and I wanted the job done now, or use the existing flexi tails that came with the tap, attach two isolation valves directly to those, connect those to the Speedfit plumbing, and then I could isolate the water if I ever had a problem there instead of turning the entire water supply off for the boat at the water pump. That was a tongue twister. Anyway, that's what I did. So again, thread those flexi tails through the nut, poke it through the worktop, and then I could screw the hose tails in from above, making sure you don't get the hot and cold water mixed up. Oh, and don't worry, I remembered the O-ring eventually because it had fallen down towards the bottom and I had to pull it back through the hole. That pesky thing, it was so small. So now I'm positioning the tap's lever where I wanted it so it didn't clash with the sink, and I'm holding it tight with my left hand while only hand tightening the screw in the barrel from underneath, just in case I had to take it apart and reconnect it later. And finally, I've now got to the point where I'm ready to fit the isolation valves. But something about them you need to look out for is that there's an arrow on the side, and that's the way the water should flow through. And here you can see that they're in an open position because you can see straight through them. And there's a little slot on the side, which I like to twist with a knife, or you can use a flathead screwdriver and turn it until you see a ball inside, which is then in the closed position. So I left it in this stage while I was working through the plumbing. Also, you'll find each compression end, those screw bits either side, come with a copper olive. But in this case, I'll only need this for the Speedfit side, not for the hose tails. So making sure that the arrow on the valve is pointing towards the tap, I'm now hand screwing one on each of the tap's flexi hose. And you might be wondering why I didn't use the old copper tails on the new tap. And that's purely because they wouldn't fit. They were a little bit too big. And the new ones, because they were longer, I was able to hold them against the old Speedfit to see where I could cut them down. But I didn't want them too short because I needed some allowance to slot them together. And there was a bit of wood in the way, so I cut them slightly above. And I used my special plastic pipe cutters for a clean cut. I wouldn't be tempted to use a hacksaw for this because you'd probably have to sand it. And I'd be worried about any burrs that you created might damage any seals on the inserts. It's just not worth the hassle. Now, as for fitting Speedfit to the brass isolation valve, you might be wondering whether you still need an insert, and you absolutely do, and an olive. I tightened everything up until I felt resistance and then gave it a full final turn while making sure that the slot is facing me so it's not at any awkward angles for anyone. Also, I didn't want to make it too tight in case the olive damaged the pipe or the insert. That was something I felt very conscious about. Plus, I knew that if I did go and inspect it later and found it slightly wet, I could just nip it up and stop it. But it does make you miss Speedfit, doesn't it?
I like that.
And then for the all important test, turn the water back on from the pump and also the new isolation valves that I've just fitted, and check to see if the water's running and there's no leaks.
Oh, right, hot and cold.
Yay! It works.
Right.
And then tighten the whole thing from the nut underneath. And I think with any plumbing, either in a new home, a boat, or something that you've just done, you do get a bit obsessed checking to see if it's damp every other day. So the next morning, I did find that the right one was slightly weepy. So like I said, I just tightened it and I've not had any problems since. But this is where I found another issue, that the waste hose from the sink had a slight drip, and later another one from the sink strain. So one job has ended up turning into three.